seeing as there's a lot of traffic in Chongqing, one of the best ways to get around is obviously the subway and the light rail system, which is what we're going to use today. So, we're outside the entrance to the Chongqing Yangtze Rampway. For people who live in Chongqing, it's just another way to get across the river. But for tourists like me, it's an essential part of the journey to Chongqing. It only costs 20 kwai for a return journey. That's considerably cheaper than the subway, but you don't get those beautiful, stunning views. So, let's go. So as we prepare to cross the longest river in Asia, I've got a feeling I'm with a lot of tourists here, so I'm going to have to try and push my way to the front to get a window spot. Get ready for a bit of a squeeze. Swings quite a bit. Be interesting. Be careful. Success! So that was it, we crossed the Yangtze River, only cost 20 kwai for that return trip. It's a deal.
The Yangtze River, or Changjiang as it's known in Chinese, is incredibly important both historically speaking and economically speaking. It contributes around 20% of the country's GDP. The river basin itself is home to a third of China's population, which is an incredible figure. You can see on the river, you've got these cruise liners. Those are for those Yangtze River cruises for the increasingly wealthy people in the cities. Unfortunately, I'm not wealthy, so I won't be going on one of those cruises. But there's lots of building work still going on alongside the river. You can see how important it is still to this very day. So really, the Yangtze River is the very lifeblood of China.
Now, despite buying a 20 kwai ticket to come one side of the Yangtze River and go back the other side, we're going to forego the return journey and instead we're going to take the light rail over the suspension bridge over the Yangtze River. The problem is finding that station.
Something tells me this isn't the way to the metro station. I don't think this is the right way. What's going on here?
Hello.
Hello, you.
Well, I've stumbled upon an old section of Chongqing. It's incredible. Right next to the developed, sprawling city, you've got small sections that are basically untouched. Well, I've decided to press on in the search for the metro station. Let's see what happens. It's almost a little bit like a labyrinth. Look at these beautiful old buildings. They're amazing. Okay, so it's crossroads time. Down or up? Well, seeing as the station is up, up.
Mm-hmm. And we've arrived. Dongshuimen. Oh, we're going to imminently arrive, I should say. And this is the entrance to the light rail metro of Chongqing. A little bit hot. It's another cheap way to travel across the city. This particular line runs underneath the suspension bridge. In we go. So we're going across the Yangtze River again, this time on the metro underneath that huge suspension bridge. And now we're going to Sisiko, or Porcelain Village, an ancient village quite far away. So just sit back, relax and enjoy the ride. And we've arrived at the entrance of Sisiko. Hello. Should be filming that. Oh, they're going to want money for this, aren't they? Quickly, let's go. Let's not get stung again. That happened to me with Mickey. That's another one. Did the Monkey King come to Chongqing on his journey to the west?
No.
Right?
The village is thought to date back around 1,000+ years, and the name can be traced back to the Qing and Ming dynasties during the time of porcelain production, because it means the porcelain village. And as you can see, it's a very popular tourist location, so I'm going to blend seamlessly in with all these shiny things.
There's a lot of shops like this here in Sisiko. No idea what they sell. Only joking, they sell spice.
I would, but they haven't got my size. I put on a few pounds recently. So we're going to go in search of some of the xiaoshi, or some of the snacks that you can find here in Sisiko. This is how much?
$8
So this is swan la far. It's a type of noodle made from sweet potato, and it looks pretty hot. It's only cost me eight yuan, so it's a good deal. So let's tuck in. As with most things in Chongqing, it's got that very, very spicy flavour. You can taste the peanuts that are in it. Very nice. It's actually very, very nice. It's not too hot. Good for me. Maybe it is a bit hot. So, just about finished my swan la far. Next, I'm going to try another Chongqing dish. It's called xiao mian. Now you can get lots of different types of xiao mian. Wan dou, zha jiang, I'm not quite sure what that is, but we're going to go for the most traditional type, Chongqing xiao mian. So, might as well order one. Now, 老板, 要一份 Chongqing xiao mian. So this is the xiao mian. It looks quite similar to the swan la far. Obviously, this is noodles made from flour as opposed to noodles made from sweet potato. It's still got the beans inside. It's got greens, scallion, onions. Let's have a taste. The flavour's pretty similar. Extremely bloody hot.
I am becoming more and more accustomed to the spicy flavours. That, or the taste buds on my tongue are all dead. Or dying. Either way, it's quite nice. That's peppery. I am British, so potato, obviously. This is bad disease. Still got lots of bone. And very spicy. We're good. Everyone around is hot and sweaty. That's because it's about 34 degrees C. But I can't tell if they are actually hot or sweaty, or if they've just eaten Chongqing hot pot. I'm just really hot and sweaty. Amid the hustle and bustle of Zhejiang, you can always find a quiet spot like this beautiful little tea house here. But be warned, places like this within the village are rather expensive, which is why I'm just drinking water. Cheers. So our day has come to an end at Zhejiang. Apparently this is the way to the subway station. I'm pretty sure it isn't the way, is it?
是,就是.
Okay, all right, so I'll go. I'll see you later, I guess. Did I disappear on the screen? All right.